TFCRadio.com.
Feeling so high, roll up that hydro, hydro make me feel fine. Roll up that hydro, hydro make me feel fine. Cook up that hydro, hydro make me feel high. Feeling so high, roll up that hydro, hydro make me feel fine. Roll up that hydro, hydro make me feel fine.
All right, it's 5 o'clock. The kitchen's open. What's cooking? Good looking, you guys out there listening to the Hydroponic Chef on DFZ Radio, Farm to Table Cannabis, proudly shown on DFZRadio.com and High Times TV. We are the only show offering you edible reviews, interviews, news, and interviews with the top names in the industry. And today is none other. We're a week away from Christmas, folks. This is going to be our Christmas episode. The phone board is lighting up, so somebody better get on that. I can't be answering my own phone calls. And we got a prank call lined up for you today. We're going to entertain you for the next hour. Farm-to-table cannabis right before the Heavy Tea Grow Show here on DFZ Radio. And we like to give you a recap on everything that happened in the week that we were gone. MJ BizCon was in full fucking effect. 30,000 Brads, Chads, Kyles, and Hunters showed up from all over the industry for a educational experience on cannabis, culture, and everything Chadwick. But we'll get to that in a minute. We always like to start the show with some news, and today is none other. We're going to take it over to Cooperstown. You know what Cooperstown's got, right? Don't you, St. Dizzle?
What?
The Hall of Fame for MLB. And nice. The MLB announced this week that they're going to stop the weed testing. So hell MLB yeah. Lifted the weed ban for minor leaguers.
Minor leaguers?
Yeah, just for minor leaguers. But it's a big step in the right direction. So weed is now legal in the MLB. When it comes to the league is lifting a ban on marijuana for minor leaguers, removing the drug from its prohibited substance list. As a part of the MLB's effort to crack down on opioid use and around the league, it's agreed to stop testing minor leaguers for cannabis. The Athletic's Ken Rosenthal reported that, of course, the MLB has already didn't test the big leaguers for marijuana, but the rule change for everyone else is the big deal for the sport. So previously, minor leaguers faced a 25-game suspension for a first positive cannabis test and 50-game for a suspension. You know what I'm hearing this? Is sorry, dude, weed's for starters. You don't get it if you're on the minors. If you want weed, you gotta be in the big leagues. Sorry, coffee's for closers, fucker. So
that's motivation.
It's another reason, yeah, to get your motivation on up there. Now, we are gonna go over to the NFL now. Where they also expect a big change coming after this policy change for MLB. So a top National Football League team owner and a star player said this week that they're expecting changes from the league's marijuana policy after the MLB announced that. So both Jerry Jones, owner of the Cowboys, and New England Patriots ex-quarterback Tom fucking Brady, Touchdown Tommy, who, you know, he definitely doesn't smoke weed. Tommy doesn't seem like the cat that, but
Probably vapes.
he definitely likes robot dick.
Now, CBD.
CBD robot dick for Tom Brady. I think that the world is sensitive to the issue regarding marijuana right now, and it's also an issue contemplated that we are going excited about and being in a step for the social and legal scene as it goes forward, Jerry Jones said. He said it with a Texas accent, so no one trusted him. Moving up, we're going to go on over to... Where are we at with this one? This is D.C. So people are skipping sleep aids in favor of marijuana, people are saying. So, by the way, this news is brought to you by Beard Bros now. It's official. We ran into them at the Emerald Cup up there, and I was like, dude, I'm already stealing your news, and I don't know if you wanted to do anything about it, but I would be cool if I just already said where it was coming from. So, you know, they looked at me, and they gave me the old, all right, that sounds good, bud. All right, yeah. So it all works out. The news brought to you by Beard Bros.
Dope. Shout out Beard Bros.
So It's good to see people are getting off of sleep aids in favor of cannabis. The scientific community is still unclear on whether or not marijuana can actually help treat sleep disturbances such as insomnia, but a new study, however, found that fewer people purchase over-the-counter OTC sleep medications when they have legal access to cannabis. So researchers at the University of New Mexico and California State Polytech University used retail scanner data collected by the Nielsen Company to help them understand how access to recreational marijuana affected the sales of OTC sleep medications purchased at local stores in and around Colorado. Well, Colorado's a depressing place already. So I imagine when the weather changes, that data's got to be just a little bit skewed. You know, when the sun's out, may less sleeping pills will go up. But when it gets fucking cold and dark out there in Colorado, it feels like another fucking world. Is it majestic? Yes. I'd like to see what their suicide rate is. Maybe Jesus pull that up. Christ. Maybe pull that one up here in a little bit here, Saint. And then we're going over to Canada, you guys. Canada's Miss Universe dressed up in a weed outfit for the pageant.
It was disgusting. I think they've seen that.
It was completely disrespectful to cannabis, but what a changing times. There is a big winner in the Miss Universe contest, and she wasn't crowned champion. She just said that she's good with weed.
So, like, we get it. You smoke, right?
Hey, it's like that. It reminds me of that one chick on the Instagram who's always taking bong rips in her weed-colored bra.
No,
like, she smoked weed her first time. And now, one last one. Over to Massachusetts, the medical marijuana customers are buying cheap, good weed, just not in Massachusetts. They're going over to Maine. So, Kittery, Maine, Ingrid Martinez is a terminally ill, undergoing chemotherapy medical marijuana patient, and it helps her alleviate her nausea and pain. She's a resident who works in medical coding. Before she got sick, she travels to Maine now every 3 weeks to buy marijuana. And although Massachusetts has a medical marijuana card for her, she said marijuana costs too much in the Bay State. Martinez had to stop using cannabis in Massachusetts because she couldn't afford it. If she can't buy more cheap medicine, she'd rather go to Maine. It's what they have, and it's what I need.
Maine has fire. I went to Boston's Canna Convention, and Jesus Christ.
Hey, I'm just saying. It's like it's a different world. You know, Maine's a little bit more rural, too, in
no
spaces.
Doubt.
So when you get out there, you get a little bit more of that craft. You're getting a little bit more of those.
Yeah, shout out Mega Raw. He's from Maine. He's crushing it. He entered some stuff at the dealie. You know.
See, the dealio that everyone goes to and enters their stuff in and hopes to further their career in this ever-changing cannabis industry. So that's the news according to the Hydro Chef. Thank you to the Beard Bros for letting us read your articles. I read it so you don't have to, guys. And we got a good show lined up for you today. We got the MJ BizCon recap. We got the Santa Rosa Emerald Cup recap. And we got none other than Masonic Seeds in the building. The man, the myth, the legend, the time-traveling genie, Masonic Smoker. So I mean, dude, like right out the rip, like everyone wants to know, like are you fucking for real? Like
about what?
Like everything you do, like half of it is a character in some people's eyes, and the other half of it is full floating bona fide most respected seed company in the industry.
I don't know, it's people like shock value, but I don't want to cross the line. I used to cross the line. Whatever, it's a journey, but this is where we're at now.
Well, this is your first appearance on the Farm to Table Cannabis Show, but not your first time at DFZ Radio Studios.
I called in one time.
Yeah, so I'm sure it was complete debauchery. You always seem to get the comment sections flowing and the phone calls lighting up. So we've got some phone calls already going, 562-653-0707. You can call in to win. We got a magic butter machine to give away. We got some other Chad sticks, some Chap sticks, some Chadwick dip dick, all that shit. So... Yeah, what is you? It's Chadwick Dick Dip. You never heard of Chad? Well, it's like lipstick, but for your dick tip.
No doubt.
So, I mean, we're reading here, and I got to do some research on you because there's just so much to understand. The Wikipedia page here says invented K&F farming. True or false? Let's go down the list for a minute because let's put some truth to some myths.
I didn't even know I had a Wikipedia link.
It's definitely official now.
No.
Are you writing your own wiki page or is this just?
No, I don't have a. I don't.
No.
I didn't edit a wiki page or make a wiki page.
Yeah, that's quite a compliment. Also, it also says here time traveling genie.
I don't know nothing about that either.
Okay. Well, it's a, I find it odd because sometimes you're...
I have deja vu here and then, but that's as close as time traveling we get.
I had a day job, too.
Deja vu.
Oh, oh, my bad. My bad. Fuck, yeah. I had to quit that shit. I started selling fucking
me too.
Roundup for a living.
No doubt. Shout out Rite Aid.
So, like, when it comes to all the myths and all the rumors out there, there's one thing that we know that you're definitely well known for, and that's genetics.
Yeah, I think I got a good taste for what's good, in essence, and I know how to, you know, put it out there correctly.
Some people say you know how to pick them. Now, you got a good catalog going. The names are unique, too. You're not marketing to kids. You're,
I make, like, one or two names. I don't make too many names. I usually just stick to the genetics. And even if, like, somebody did give it to me with a name, and it's, like, five crosses, like, I'm not going to, or, like, they don't know that name, I'll just call it the strain name just to, so I don't have to explain to everybody what such and such name is. You know.
So we're going to get to that in a minute because we're going to have to ask you if you spin this wheel of magic naming or if it just goes up to the lineage. But there's definitely some artist to what you're doing. Now, for everyone that doesn't know, you're coming out of Los Angeles, Crenshaw.
Compton, California.
Compton. I didn't mean to give away your home address there. He's at 2372. Don't mind.
Hey, chill, man.
Next thing you know, he's got everyone knocking on the doors, like at your granny's house trying
to. Now, they know where I'm at. I'm pretty transparent and like gutsy sometimes. I'll be on live rolling down literally the street that you could find me at any given time of the day.
Well, that's what's weird in this world right now is you've got to be so accessible to be able to do this and do this in a right way. And it wasn't always like that. You come from a world where you didn't even want to be on the radio shows before. There was years. I mean, I met you when you were first doing the character. I'm going to call it character because you were still that guy.
No doubt.
It was just now you're in the public's eye.
Yeah.
But, you know, you didn't want to do the radio show. That wasn't your thing. But now you've been able to find a way to where this has worked to your advantage. The getting deleted 20 times in a year has you've been able to spin this shit on its head.
No doubt.
Now, you're in a unique position because you do have access to some of the most, what are we going to call these? Because I don't want to say strains. When did this strange thing start?
It started just me. I don't know. I play with a lot of, there's a lot of terms.
Are you a rapper?
No, I coined a lot of phrases. I like
false
to think.
I'm writing,
you know
that
what I mean?
Off the Wikipedia, a rapper.
Rapping is that's probably what I'd be doing if I wasn't doing this. I'm just kidding. I just rap to myself. But either way, I coined some stuff. Like, I'll just shove stuff down people's throat. You know what I mean? I'll call it mids, even though it's not. I say tap in. I say on my way. So you'll see people just say on my way. Like, they'll post something cool and they'll put on my way. That's because I did that.
So what amount of what you're doing is seriously trolling and what amount just ended up turning into just great marketing?
It started really, I mean, it was kind of malicious at first. You know, I just wanted to get people riled up, especially if I didn't kind of like them. But I've gone to a position where that's not good for business. So I've squashed all those old beefs of me trolling people for real. Because there's people that troll behind a puppet account.
So, because looking down the Wikipedia page, you true or false, you did start Jungle Boys.
No.
Okay, false. Okay, my bad. That's, again, fucking guys up there with that shit.
That's ridiculous. All that, he created this, that turned into a monster, if anything. But it is what it is, you know? Because, like I said, just... It is what it is.
Allegedly. It is. See, and that's what it is sometimes because he comes from a background where we didn't do a lot of talking. You didn't brag about your grow. You didn't brag about your strains. You definitely didn't talk about doing business, which is, you know, this is all for show, obviously. But there's a big element to of it that is a branding that we've got to talk about when we come back in a minute from the commercial break about how going forward into 2020 you're going to market yourself, market the seed company, market everything you're doing with your strands. And that'll be the word of the show, folks, strands. If I ask you a question today about the Magic Butter Machine, whatever the fucking, you better answer strands, all right? So we'll be back. DFZ Radio, Farm to Table Cannabis. Hold on the line, callers. When we come back, we're going to take some calls. We'll make a prank call. We might even do some Christmas songs. I got this dope for you. I rum pum pum pum.
Kissing crazy swell underneath the hydro shop last night. He didn't see. well was leaking. And then Cody walked up and he opened up the doors. I saw Duffman kissing Turbinator last night underneath the hydro shop last night. And then he took some gel. Rizo, I could tell. When he had a very good time. Good times. It wasn't mommy, it was Duffman. Duff, let the crazy swell go. How is Mitch gonna feel about this? The deal is, it's Christmas time. DLZ listeners, happy holidays.
I saw mommy tickle Santa.
It wasn't Santa, it was Heavy T.
Underneath his beard so smooth.
They were tickling Heavy T's. Tickling those titties. Aw, T. It's so ticklish, T.
What's the load factor, sir?
We're here.
Bringing
calling
the Rizo Blast
Radio
liquid
to table
at 2 mils per gallon.
The number's over there, 562-653.
Okay, sir. We are loaded and ready to launch.
707. You can call in.
Okay, man. It's time to blast off into the plant's root zone and into another galaxy of root growth.
Rizo Blast is a proprietary blend of seaweed and the single-celled algae Chlorella. Chlorella's abundance of amino acids and minerals contribute to its value in hydroponics. The benefits using Rizo Blast are explosive root growth, used with any growing medium or hydro system, its ideal use for transplanting, and the enhancement of your plant vigor and fast-flowering plants. Let your plants have a blast and see a world of a difference with Rizo Blast from Botanicare. Check it out at www.botanicare.com.
DFCRadio.com.
Four callers, 562-653-0707.
We're back. Farm to Table Cannabis, DFC Radio. You missed the behind the scenes action. I was trying to get Masonic to smoke some of my mids. And it's got to be hard for him because all these people, they want to talk about strands to you, right? And I imagine you get a lot of gifts.
No doubt, no doubt. Like, lots and lots of a plethora of gifts that I got this weekend.
How do you tell someone their baby's ugly?
You don't. You don't. You'd never do that.
Because in my day-to-day, I am forced to do that, unfortunately. People do think their flower's good, and you have to tell them, like, oh, that looks like some heat damage was here. All in all, it was good. But there is a little je ne sais quoi of how you explain it to them about how shitty their baby is. One of the ones is, ooh, this would fire, but it could have been even better if, that's a good way.
If I buy weed off you, hash off of you, it's probably good.
A good compliment, for the most part. Definitely. Yeah.
That's as far as we're gonna get, because I'll reach out and make sure I get some more.
Dude, you ever did a pity buy like the dude at the fucking? You ever done a pity buy for someone like the dude at the fucking mall with the CD?
I've done pity buys before.
Oh my God, had no intention on smoking the tree, or you accepted it, had no intention on
it. It happens, man.
Hey, it's hard to tell someone their baby's ugly. Yeah. Now, recap. I'm about to, go over the MJ BizCon event, and that was a good event, and just crazy amount of Chads, Brads, Kyles, and Hunters, and a lot of dad's money there, you know? And
I missed that one, but that's the second time I miss it, but I should go to the next one.
Well, I can just imagine a Masonic booth there, and you were just slinging T-shirts the whole time and saying, hey, holler at me in a minute, or, tap in, hit the DM.
Yeah.
Right. Just getting work done the old-fashioned way, and that's what's missing from these trade shows, because a lot of these cats at these shows, it's weird, they've never touched a plant in their life. A lot of them want to get in the industry, never touched a plant in their life.
Big facts.
Now, it's a ever-changing industry, and there's a lot of investors at those things. And going into 2020, what do you think stores hold for someone like you with so much knowledge of genetics and such a catalog that you have? Is there an opportunity for investment? Is there something about branching out in 2020 that appeals to you? Or is it, I'm from the street in Compton, if you want to buy a T-shirt, tap in?
I don't know. It's a branding, a whole lot of branding going on. And if I know there's a lot of licenses and things you need like that, but I don't know what to tell you. Like, whoever's got the money is going to be winning, obviously. You know what I mean? But
saw a lot of young entrepreneurs over there at these events. And yeah. They were the guys that actually touched the cannabis. They've been doing it their whole life. They grew up in a world where weed had pretty much always been legal for them. Young cats, 21 years old, 25 years old, going to this investor conference at the MJ BizCon. So you would go to a separate conference where people would listen to your idea and your pitch and hear it. And, young cats that you would never, ever suspect, they were pulling out decks, making pitches to investors, and securing funding at this event. So as much as I do joke about the MJ BizCon being full of a bunch of Chads and Brads, if you can get that Chad money or that Brad money or Chad's Brad's dad's money, you better jump on that shit, because
no doubt.
Very few people out there willing to make that leap and believe in you. And it's even rarer for you to have an opportunity to pick. And when you brand yourself, and I'm going to use you as an example right now. I was talking about Mystery Baking because those guys just kill it. But branding the way yourself that you've done it, that's opening the opportunities. There's doors where you can pick instead of having to rely on someone finding you. So it's a unique world we're living in, where someone who can bring an idea to the table, bring a character, if you will, and create a brand off of that. Now, at MJ BizCon, it was missing a little bit of the culture. And
I'd imagine
that's where you see a lot of more
suits
and ties.
You can't even smoke there, some deal like that.
You can't really smoke there outside. I'll tell you what we were doing a little bath salts out there, and that was a good time. But no faces were harmed. But on the other side of the culture thing, the same weekend was Santa Rosa's Emerald Cup. A notoriously culture event. We heard a little bit of complaints. People were a little bit mad about parking. People were a little mad about attendance. A lot of people called that, similar to a Wookiee Fest now, as opposed to what it used to be. But at the same time, the turnout was phenomenal.
I mean, I didn't know what it used to be. I've only gone twice,
Well, what are your impressions then, Masonic? You're attending this for your second time. The first year was
a whole lot of networking.
The first year was a bad year. It was a hydropocalypse, if you will. The fires happened up north, a lot of smoke weed up there, and not in a good way. So what was your interpretation of the second event?
It was dope. I really enjoyed it. Networked, got to link with a lot of people, and I don't know. It was cool. It was like felt like Disneyland at one point when I was buying stuff. Not Disneyland, but like a kid in a candy store. I don't really care for Disneyland.
I'm more of a Comic-Con type of guy, If you will say one thing about Emerald Cup, it was like the Comic-Con of the cannabis industry. There was kids dressed up. I mean, there was fucking full-floating Wookiees there. I'm talking Star Wars and not Star Wars. It was a true festival, if you will.
Yeah.
Now, shout out to all the folks that won. I was up there catering a brunch for Clout King and Monterey Kush Co. And
yeah, Kalia Extracts actually sweep the competition. That's my homie right there.
Work,
shout
working
out
with
OG.
The homies out there. That's
Ice House Extracts.
Amazing products.
That's
you
the
mean.
Homie. Ice House Melts. Sorry about that, but yeah, that's the homie. Triple OG. Go.
When you see it, you support that shit because it's not hard. You look at it and you're like, wow, I'm taking that home. Yeah, no wonder that's a winner. Yeah. So. From the Emerald Cup, day one and day two, you did both days?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, see? Now, the acts were good. They, you know, they had some unique things you don't usually see at other than only at festivals, you know? And there wasn't, like, the rap music that you would normally see it there. It was, like, good times, chill vibes. The glass, I think, was suffering, you know?
I mean, I kind of, like, just met people. I get, like, you know, it's, like, a lot to digest. So, like, I kind of did try to geek out a little bit, so I sat down and watched the award ceremony, but then it's, like, back on my feet. Oh, you got to link up with me. You got to link with me. I'm over here. I'm over
there.
Now,
you're always busy there, but you caught me in two rare moments at the Cup. One of them was at the end when I was super faded drunk, and we'll talk about that in a minute, but other one was a couple hours before that when I was fucking... I mean, I'll let you tell a story because you'll do it more justice than I will. I'll make myself look better than I was.
This fool was bartering for a freaking pipe, and he just nonstop. And I'm like, "What are you doing?" And how much was the pipe? $600?
It was an $800 pipe. And I look over, and I'm not hitting this cat from Romania hard, right? I'm telling him,
yeah, the Romanian.
I'm hitting
cat.
Him with the buddies. I'm like, I'm coming Eastern European, like thick on. Hey, buddy, come on, bro. You don't know how to bargain. I thought you was a gypsy. You're not a gypsy. Come on. And then I look
Jesus
over, and Masonic
Christ.
Is sitting right there, watching
that.
Me try to talk this guy down $200. Needless to say, he was saying no. I send my fucking final offer over to there through a comrade at work. Hey, just go ask him one more time. I think he's tired of dealing with me. My buddy says to him, respectfully, sir, sorry for my friend. He would just like to buy this bong off you. This is the final offer. You may choose to accept it or not. And the guy took it.
Jesus.
So Christ. I took that bong home.
What'd you get it for, like 40% off or something like that?
$575.
All right. That's dope.
I still feel like a Nazi, but worth it all the way.
I was about to make a really bad joke after that Nazi reference, but it's not gonna happen.
You're in a safe zone here. But shout out to the glass artist. He was really nice to work with, but no free shout outs till you come on the show, as we discussed. And so at the end of the day, Emerald Cup was a big success. I think it brought out the culture, and they needed a good event after the 2018 hydropocalypse and fires and everything that went on up there. So all in all, great networking, a lot of legal cannabis. You're not going to fucking be able to purchase shit there. There's, you know, black market cannabis or a bootleg vape pen for that matter. You will be paying $80 for a cartridge. Don't sweat it. But
totally worth it.
But knowing that you're getting clean product, I guess would be a way to look at it and say, you know, that might be worth it. But gosh,
I mean, shout out the clean product. There was a couple snowman packs with some moldy buds on them, but that's just that. You know, I'm not being a hater, but you know,
you got to call it for what you see.
You know, that's what happened this weekend, right? You know,
listen up,
it happened.
They came out in all the glory.
But all
good
that
weed,
and
bad weed,
all that weed, man. If I was in a position with all that weed, you got to put themselves in that shoe. You know, like, I mean, what would I do? I don't freaking know. I never had that much money. Would I just like be greedy and, you know, who knows? Maybe I think it's clean. No, let's make that money. Or maybe maybe they were doing it with malicious intent and they knew it was, you know,
they just
dirty
want to sell
packs,
their fucking mold
but they
weed.
Want their money. Who knows what, you know? Hopefully it's, you know, it's too much QC for them, you know, quality control, that, you know, some stuff slips through the cracks. And, you know, I'm not, like I said, I'm not a hater. It happened. And, you know, hopefully it was that. You know what I mean?
That's not a thing that's going to continue at the Cups. Let's see people bring their A game. But all in all, I think the Cup was a success. We should be glad that there still are these fucking events, because I'm worried that in the future there might not be things like this. I mean, we've watched them change, a big, big change from the way these festivals used to be ran, with, you know, only supporting the black market, now to only supporting the legal market. And, you know, let's just hope we can at least hold on to the little bit of culture we got left. Now, we'll end the review there, but we do have some people online. You mind taking some phone calls? They might prank us.
Who knows what's the deal?
I know you got your fucking wit on quick. Where are you calling in from, caller? You're on the line with Hydro Chef and Masonic.
Hey, I'm calling from Los Angeles. This is Todd.
What's up, Todd? So,
what's going on, man?
I'm Sofa King.
What up, Todd?
What up?
Talk to me,
and
Todd.
Shout out for Masonic. He's a big inspiration for all us small up-and-comers, you know, repping our city, putting out the fire. And just wanted to say shout out, brother. And Watt Power.
Oh my God!
Damn it! Oh, if you have hate in your heart, don't bring that shit here.
Worldwide, and hell yeah, brother! All
right, we're gonna call that one for a minute.
I'm sorry about that.
No sweat. We'll send that guy a fucking white bandana.
Off good, yeah.
All right, next caller. We're going away from LA. Caller, where are you calling in from?
Man, in the middle of nowhere, it's bad motherfucker Jay.
What up, Jay? Are you in Australia right now? Where are you at?
Sydney?
No, I'm out here in weak-ass Chicago, fam. It's 16 degrees.
Oh, wow. My God. He's sound depressed as
shit. That's the homie right there. Shout out. I was like, who is that? And then I seen it, Chicago, and I'm like, okay, he's in Chicago for sure.
You recognize that voice.
That's the Compton homie right there.
He's smooth as a motherfucker, Jay. Hey, Jay, who's taking care of the motherfucking hoop house?
Man, shit, I done shut down operation, moved it out here.
Holy shit.
That's why I'm calling and holler at you, Chef. What's up with those LED lights?
Oh, man. See, now you're talking my language. So there was a lot of LEDs at that fucking MJ BizCon. It was crazy. There was damn near as many LED companies as there was packaging companies and CBD companies owned by a China kid whose dad lived in motherfucking overseas. But at the same time, you got to be able to decipher what's good and what's just some Amazon blurple lighting. Some hoo-hoo. It's like Hootie with no fish, basically. You don't want to have Hootie and no blowfish. So
I definitely don't.
So hear me out. I'm going to give you a quick rundown why I think the Gavita LED is seriously the top light in the industry right now. 1,100 more diodes than any other light in the entire fucking convention. 3,400 count. You're looking at 92% white, 8% red, white Samsung, red Osram diodes, and you're getting the full spectrum with the ability to dim it down. Now, right now, currently, with those diodes, they're running them not even at full strength, so you're not getting that burnout that you'd experience with some of these other lights that have to get run at full power to even hit that 1,700 U-moles, micromole. So if you're doing it, you might as well do it right, because I'm a big advocate of anything worth doing, you should do right. Spend the extra $100-$150, get the adapter. That way you're using the top of the line, brand new state of the art electronic LED lighting that's going to have a 5-year warranty, because your company's only LEDs warranty is only as good as the company is, right? If the company's been around longer than 5 years, I fuck with you. If you ain't been around 5 years, you're trying to drop a 5-year warranty, who the fuck are you? And that's right. LED, according to the Hydro Chef. I'm going to send you a magic butter machine to Chicago so you can make some ice cream in the cold. Will you make me a snow cone, Jay?
Hey, man, it's plenty of snow cones out here for you.
Don't eat the yellow snow.
Hey.
It's not limited.
And stay safe out there, man. Don't take no shit from those swine. I know you just went from a legal state to a motherfucking gray state, so... you know, don't be putting your neck out there if you don't have to.
No, we having fun out here, though. Boys, it go green in January.
Can't wait to hear what you do with it, man. I've always seen you. You're one that can make it anywhere. If you make it in L.A., you're going to kill it in Chicago. Watch out, Chi-Town.
Yeah. The LEDs that you're talking about, that's the ones that sold out on Gavita's website right now?
they damn near sold out, but no, we have them, and there is a borderline shortage. So get your LED order in now. If shit is popping.
Because it's two series of them. I think on the lower series on the website, that one's all sold out, and then on the higher base.
So the difference, the difference comes down to where the plug is mounted and where the plastic diodes are covered or not. The new model doesn't have the plastic covering the diodes. It has a little polyvinyl plastic over it, so it's wet rated. The other one's not wet rated. Mm. Water resistant, but not wet rated.
Gotcha.
Okay. Can you dig it, my brother?
Yeah, I can dig it. I definitely think that they're worth the $1,400 or $1,500. Like you said, these other companies, they offer a warranty, but shit, they haven't even been in the game as long as they're warranted.
No, you got it. You hit it right on the head there. So I'm going to send you out that prize. We don't need your address. You DM it to me, and then I'll come visit you in Chicago and eat all your food and take your snow cones.
All right, thanks, brother. Masonic, I'll see your ass on Saturday or Sunday, motherfucker.
All right, G, I'll catch you later, fool.
All right.
All right.
Peace.
So Sonic's got the phone lines open. We got a couple callers. I'm going to take one and see what happens here. DFZ Radio, Farm to Table Cannabis. You're on the line with Masonic and the Hydro Chef. That's okay.
Hello?
Yeah, you're here. Masonic and
hey,
the Hydro Chef.
This is Lee. This is Lee out of Los Angeles. Shout out Masonic. You know, he's a great guy. Represents the master race.
It's the same
if he's going to say white power.
The master race.
Oh my
Welcome
God!
Welcome to DFZ Radio, Farm to Table Cannabis,
brother.
All right, is this
hello?
Yes, is this the Grand Dragon?
Is this the Grand Wizard?
Oh, dude, I'm finally on. What's up, people? It's the House of Wax.
That's what's good,
yeah.
Man. Thanks for calling in.
Yeah,
what up, folks?
Bullshitting here, dabbing. Thought I'd call you guys and fucking say what's good. Hope everything's well with you guys. Hope everything's puffing, you know? What are you guys smoking on tonight?
We're puffing
some
tough.
CRC, homie. You already know the deal. We're doing the BHO hash rosin dabs over here, homie. 50, one-to-one ratio.
Do you want collabs on brands or what?
What?
He wants to collab
you
on some slabs.
You forcing the collabs?
Yeah, I'm forcing the collabs. You already know the deal. No loop.
Fucking 80 bucks a half gram, tap in.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
But yeah, man, just want to say what's good. Fucking Everlasting Flavored, fucking Or Die, hit me up.
Yeah, shout out House of Wax. That's one of my ghost breeders. He actually made Everlasting Fire.
Damn.
Hey, the kid. What's good, guys? Have a good night, guys.
Representing. Thanks
for
calling in, my dude.
Of course.
You hold on a minute. We're going to send you some samples to try in your garden. You can give us a shout out courtesy of Masonic.
Cool, man. Thank you. I appreciate it.
I'm going to put you on hold. Give the screen your address so I can come rub your house. DFZ Radio, Farm to Table Cannabis, you are the winning caller of the night. Who is it and where are you calling from?
Hey, what's going on, man? This is Matt from Jersey.
Is this him again? No, all right, as long as it's not white power guy again. All right.
No, it's not.
All right. Tell me you love all people.
I love all people.
Sing It's a Small World After All.
You're good.
I'm like, dude, it's not me.
All right.
It's me.
So did you have a question for Masonic, or did you have a gardening question or a cooking with cannabis question, or you just want to call in, tap in?
Well, I definitely was trying to win a butter machine, but I do have a question for Masonic. I just wanted to know, you know, what really got him started on wanting to breed and, you know, what he has in store next, what's next up and coming.
I was about to say it's a money grab, but
yeah, keep it off the
cuff. Man, I've been growing for like, I'm 27. I've been growing for like 10 years in my backyard. I've made like seeds accidentally. People inquired, found out, you can make crosses, made more, and started giving away seeds. Next thing you know, people want to buy them. Next thing you know, you got a seed company. You know what I mean?
Right. Awesome, man. And what do you have in store next? Is there big thing that you're working on, or you just?
I'm doing a project with Capulator right now. We're doing Shiver Me Timbers cross to Wilson. I just got a bunch of genetics from a whole bunch of other respected breeders that I'm gonna hit to my Wilson. So, you know, everything's in store. I'm trying to do some reversals. I just did some CBD THCs. We're gonna grow those, test those out, see how those break down. Did some type of autos that are not fully auto. We're gonna try and make those full autos. You know, we're just doing a little bit of everything. Just grabbed all the cuts from Purple City Genetics that they had available at the Emerald. We're gonna hit those. It's just you know,
don't have to wait in line.
We just do that shit.
When he gets up to the Emerald Cup, you don't have to sit there in line.
I'm pretty nice about it. You know what I mean? I wait in line, or if it's a long line, I just won't even go. You know, but I don't just cut the line. I did once or twice, but I don't do that. I'm pretty respectful about that.
Yeah, lucky you, man. Yeah. Well, hey, bud, we're going to hook you up with that magic butter machine you were wishing for Christmas. All right, just sit on Santa's lap and tell me what you want.
Oh, man, much love to you guys, man. Thank you. I appreciate that.
That's real, right. Real. I'm a red man, but I come down the chimney, but I'm not Santa, so watch out. That shit will get you arrested.
I'll put some cookies for you to smoke.
That's it. That's dope. Attaboy, you get it. So farm to table
Burner's
cannabis.
Burner's going
to
break in, bro. Careful.
Yeah, watch out, baby. Uncle Burn comes walking in with his 5 o'clock shadow.
Gangsta.
R.I.P.
All right, my dude.
Thank you guys.
Thanks
I
a lot. Send me your address or stay on the line for the screener. All right. So big ups to all you callers out there. Masonic brings the heat for the people on the phone lines. I'm over here chewing on shit, forgetting I'm doing a radio show, having fucking dinner on the radio. So yeah, we were talking a minute, like the black market versus the white market, and like you see everything that's going on in the black market right now. You see the raids going on at the beginning of the season. Things haven't really slowed down much. It's created a vacuum, a power vacuum, when it comes to like the pricing, when it comes to like the availability. I mean, gardening products are at an all-time high demand. What's in store for 2020 for you, man? Is it black market all the way? Is it promote the brand, focus on that? And we asked about investors. That's not an option.
Nah, investors is like, as long as it, you know, makes sense. But I don't think that's a possibility. I kind of know a couple, you know, seed makers, and I don't see none of them kind of doing that, you know. Man, it's kind of like wherever the wind takes me, you know. Like, I know I'm not doing nothing too crazy wrong, you know what I mean? So it's not like I'm over here, you know, with thousands and thousands of pounds of weed. You know, it's just like, you know, a couple of seeds here and there.
You're diversifying the strains. You're staying true to the people. It seems like you're one of the least hated on most liked guys when it comes to seeds. You know, you don't have a lot of fucking hard time like some of these other companies out there. Ho ho ho! Heavy T just walked in the room. You know, how do you balance between the culture and the black market?
Ooh, I just do me, man. I don't know. The culture, I totally get it. Like, if that's what we got to do, we'll do it, you know. Not the culture, but, you know, following, you know, legislation and all that. But I just know what I know, and I just do it. And it's working for me right now.
Yeah. Now, it's always going to be around, you know. Like, it's not going to – black market's not going anywhere. They're talking about lowering the taxes now. Do you think that's going to save the white market right now? Is that what you think it needs, or is it BMC over everything?
I think you know, people like fake stuff per se. You know, so there's always going to be a market for shitty weed. So that's where they kind of fall in line. Black market. People usually find the black market because you know, they're in a state where they can't buy it, or, you know, it's just way better than the stuff they'll find at MedMen per se.
Or it's might be their favorite meme page on Instagram.
That too.
Now, how did the meme thing start for you? Like, seriously, where the fuck does this chicken shit come from?
The chicken went viral. That's just the old, I take care of chickens. I raise chickens here and there as pets, not to eat. I'm not a vegetarian, just to back that comment up. But I just took a picture one day. 2 years later, I posted it on Instagram, and then I have a buddy who's pretty good with Photoshop. He did one Photoshop of it, and then that turned into, like, you know, 100 pictures of me in odd settings with the chicken. So my other buddy's like, yo, you got to put that on a shirt. Boom, went on a shirt. Oklahoma was shortly after, you know, gave out a bunch of chicken shirts over there, and, you know, the chicken went, you know, went viral for sure.
the chicken working for you.
Yeah.
Now, we got to take a quick break. We're going to come back, but I'm going to ask you what's going on with the chat epidemic in the hydro world right now. And then we got to keep on rolling with the show. And because we got Heavy T on the cord right now.
Yeah.
We just found out we are not paying sponsors tonight.
Hey, check this out. We are gonna pay our sponsors, but we do have a special guest aside from Masonic in the house. Much love, Masonic, by the way, dude. Hanging out, talking chickens and seeds and everything else that's happening. I've been enjoying the interview, but coming up, also Chef on the Heavy T Grow Show, we got Masonic And we got the one and only Spanky Hayes, the comedian from Wildin' Out.
No,
he's going to be coming in and dropping what's up tonight, too. So stay tuned. The Heavy T Grow Show and the Hydroponics Chef. But, you know, not to cut you off, Chef, and, like, steal your thunder or nothing.
Well, yeah. Well, hey, you know? Hey, I go my Sonic. He tried to one-up me right there.
Oh, man. Shout out Spanky Hayes.
Let's take a call. Let's take a caller real quick, and then we'll cut to a commercial break. Where are you calling in, caller, from? Don't you say Grandmaster's Church.
No more Grand
Church.
Wizardy, please. It's the Grand Wizard again.
It's totally the Grand Wizard. He's like, shit. I'd just like to say.
Hello, hello.
Well, yeah, it's all good. But you're in for a treat tonight, folks, because when we come back, Masonic and Chef are going to talk about the new album coming out, and it's Chad Sings the Christmas Songs. DFZ Radio, Farm to Table Cannabis. We'll be right back. All right, we're back. It's a holiday season. It's that time of year again. And we'd like to tell you about a new album coming out to spread the holiday cheer for the Chads out there. And this is your newest Christmas episode and album by Chatty McChatterson. Grandma got run over by my vape pen, smoking on the sesh on Christmas Eve. You can smoke your cartridges from Black Market, just accept that it's got vitamin E. And whoever forgot such classics as Chatty Boy, Drummer Boy. I got lots of Chads in here, bro, 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 bro. There's a lot of Chads in here, bro, 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 bro. And Christmas holiday classics like... Oh, Avid Tree, oh, Avid Tree, I will sell you for 32. Oh, Avid Tree, oh, Avid Tree, the old low is the new, new. And rounding off with an amazing rendition of... Oh, basalt, I want for basalt. All I want for Christmas are some bath salts. Only bath salts will do. All I want for Christmas is some bath salts. Only some bath salts will do. And that is the upcoming album for the holidays by Chaddy McChatterson in the Chadwick Orchestra. We're back, DFZ Radio, Farm to Table Cannabis. We're ad-libbing over here, having some fun. Masonic's in the studio. Black Market Cultivator just walked in.
He dabbing it up.
Hey, what's a Deck the Point December? What is it now?
Deck the Point December. No, it's Octa Point October. And then I don't think we thought of anything for December. It was No Deal November. So we got to think of a December thing like...
I say we just break them down to straight dime bag Decembers.
Dime bag December. That's all that's available.
Dime bag December.
We're 10 all the way up.
Hell yeah.
That's it. Get your stocking stuffers while you can.
That's
get
point
while
five
hot.
For 10.
So,
0.5 for 10 all December.
So speaking of stocking stuffers, I'm going to put you on the cuff real quick here, Masonic. You know, let's go down your list and your top three stocking stuffers from your catalog of availability of what you think is the best backyard breed right now.
Oh man, just you want to go with the Wilson F2. They dump about 6% if you're into making hash. Boom boom. So
number two on the list of Masonic's buyer's guide for genetic strands.
Get yourself the Biscotti Wilson menthols. Those should be dope.
And that one's definitely Uncle Burner approved.
Yeah, shout out Big Burn. So last one,
third on the list. And a partridge in a
these
pear tree.
Just, off top, G33I95 Wilson. Shout out Bloom Seed Co. Yeah, all that stuff is rippers.
Now, dude, you be trolling celebrities. It's so fucking funny sometimes. I can't tell if you're beefing or if you're fun with them. True or false, you worked in the Jungle Boys facility?
I've never worked in
that. those are all Photoshopped pictures. Okay, great. True or false, Burner is your uncle.
Burner is not my uncle.
Did you pay for Burner to give you a cameo?
Nah, that's totally real, bro.
That shit is so
yeah, he shouted him out.
Yeah.
That was a legit shout out from Burner. Shout out Big Burn.
Hell yeah.
And then last but not least, man, if you weren't doing this, what would you be doing, dude?
I'd be at Rite Aid Pharmacy giving your grandma her freaking high blood pressure medicine, bro.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, saving people's lives. That's what I used to do.
In essence. You're a legend, man. You're one of the rare characters in this industry. I mean, I don't know about what year you just decided to let your hair down and just start saying, I don't give a fuck what anyone thinks, and these seeds are mine now, and your meme is mine now, and this industry is mine now, but it's great. You're one of the industry's rare creatures, too weird to live and too fucking rare to die. We salute you for the seeds and for all the fucking... debauchery you bring along with it.
Thanks, buddy.
And you know, without dick riding or anything, we're gonna let you take these next three calls because they're gonna be for you anyway.
All right,
we might as well just see what the fuck happens on our way out to the Heavy T Grow Show. We got the crew from Wildin' Out into this motherfucker.
Yeah,
Sleepy,
Scrappy,
we got
whatever his
Spanky
name.
Hayes.
Spanky.
Yeah. Hey, Rudolph, hey, that motherfucker, Dancer's here. Prancer,
yeah, Dancer,
Donner,
Prancer,
that
Dixon.
Motherfucker Blitzen owes me money. If I catch Rudolph, it's off with his nose.
That one nose is red for a reason.
Mm-hmm. One of the like Horty Chris. Sure, hey, what's up? Guy. You're calling, and you got Masonic on the line. He's going to take over from here. This is the Masonic takeover.
What up? How can I help you today? Masonic.
Welcome to Rite Aid.
Welcome to Rite Aid.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Man, this Rich Mason, man, in St. Louis. Don't stand me up next time you come up here for the motherfucking hockey games, man.
No doubt, man.
Yeah, man. I was trying to goddamn track you down, man. So, you know, I already got a couple of them packs, man. Shit, everything going good, man. Just big up to you, man.
Nah, shout out St. Louis, man.
Yeah. For sure. So all right, man.
All right, man.
That's what's up, St. Louis. Where else are we going on the map here? I want to take this call. Where are you calling in from? You're on the line with Masonic Smoker at Rite Aid.
What up? What up?
Am I on?
Yeah.
Yeah, how can we help you? Did you need a prophylactic or what's up? You want a long-ass receipt?
No, I just want to show some love to the homeboy Masonic. You know, it's Mid-City Trees right here.
What up, fool? Shout out Mid-City.
I'm calling to show the homie that show some love, you know?
Yeah, man.
Shout out to, you know, the magical butter machines, man. You know, they've been helping me make all these edibles, too. Fucking people loving them. Again, I just wanted to show some love.
Yeah, shout out Mid-City Trees. It. That's the homies. He makes fire edibles. Holler at him.
Yeah. Keeping them educated and educated, play.
Yeah, man.
Turn your radio off next time when you call in so we don't hear the echo. But I'm going to go out here. I think we got someone calling in from North Korea.
North Korea in the house.
Yeah, hey.
Y'all, is it true that you invented Korean natural farming?
Yes, I did.
Carla, you're on the air.
What up, what up?
Carla, where you call from? I blow your fucking country off the planet. Where you call from?
Not there.
Oh, I'm here. You just don't hear me. I put you in bamboo cage. You feel my rage.
Shit.
All right, well... That could have been fun, but we're going to end that one.
I know. I really wanted someone from Korea to be on the line. That would have been awesome.
All right. So, you know, a lot of different ways to grow out there. We see a lot. We don't get to talk a ton of grow. We'd usually talk about cooking here and whatnot. But, bro, preferred grower method, Coco Ninja, Rockwell Scientist.
I'm a dirty soil boy.
He's a dirty old caveman.
Yeah. Soil caveman.
We love it. Yeah. We love it here. The hair gave it away. The Captain Caveman. We knew he was a soil. Even for the cuts and the young ones too.
Soil all the way, man.
100 cups filled with soil. That's solo the, cups in the background.
That's all I know how to work with soil.
That's the way.
Yeah.
Now, you know, the seasons. You hear everything going down. You hear the crazy stuff. You hear helicopter stories. You've seen people deal with this in the area. What is the protocol when you hear the choppa?
I've got a scare once or twice growing backyard in Compton.
No.
And I cut everything down. I wasn't going to have it.
Now, I'm going to go back to a good old saying from Dutch. A well-placed rock can take down a helicopter. That forever will be remembered.
We're not condoning throwing rocks at helicopters here on DFC Radio.
Right. You're on the line with the Anarchy Network. And Masonic, thanks for calling.
Is this the guy from Korea?
He's got his radio on in the background. We can't hear him.
What up?
Turn your radio off, and where are you calling from, caller?
Oh, yo, am I on?
Yeah, what's up? What's up?
Oh, what's up, dude?
Who this?
Nico.
Nico, what up, Nico? Freaking crazy ass Nico.
I just want to let you know, yo, always remember to suck your bolsita early in the morning, all right?
What'd you say? I didn't hear you. You said it too fast.
Come on, Nico from L.A., slow it down.
I'm turn off this radio.
Turn off the
I
radio.
Have it off already. I turned off my browser.
All right.
We need you to flush the toilet three times.
I love you. Yo, I just want to call in, supporting. Yo, I fucking love you, fool. That's all. All
right, Foolio. I'll catch you later.
I love you, fool. Remember, Porsche Light OG, Por Vida.
All righty.
Porsche Light OG, Por Vida.
Yeah, that is a real
a lot
strain.
Of love going on.
Porsche Light OG.
You're on the line, Farm to Table Cannabis, Masonic Smoker. How can we help you?
What up?
Yeah, what's going on?
How's it going?
So you're calling from North Korea.
No, can you guys hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you perfectly.
Oh, right on, man. This is Future Generation Farms, man. I got some of your packs, and I've been rocking your shirt, man, trying to represent you over here on the East Coast, man.
Shout out you,
I'm
man.
I'm pretty happy, man. Yeah.
Shout out you, bro.
It's real good.
Thanks for tapping in, bro.
Yeah, man. You guys have a good one.
Have a happy holiday, bro. Drive safe.
Yeah, you too.
Peace.
All right, later.
So, man, you be bringing the crowd, and you be bringing the good genetics, good attitude, and good laughs.
Yeah.
So, how does this get evolved to the next level? Because I mean, the shirts, the memes. Oh, you got to put on a mascot now.
Nah, it's all gravy.
Yeah, like it doesn't get any better. He's living the dream. Yeah.
So, bowling with fucking Masonic Sunday mornings.
We do bowlings. They bowled last night. I've been like I said, I'm a little under the weather, so I couldn't go bowl last night. And then I almost chopped off my finger, and then my back gave out.
Little trim crew incident.
And then Emerald. It was like just a whole bunch of shit happening, so I missed out on bowling for like.
He started it, and I'll see they'll go bowl without him when he can't make it. Yeah. They're like, we're still bowling.
Keeping the culture going. Yeah. Yeah, that's it. So anybody you want to give a shout out to before we take off and start the Heavy Tea Grow Show? You're gonna sit in here for a little bit with us and talk some grow.
Yeah, no doubt. I'll sit in here for a bit, but shout out the homie Mackie Mota, I-Beam Poppin, Long Beach Reefer. Yeah, these are like you know, the homies that, you know,
real ones.
I
want
to shout out. Yeah, I want to shout them out just because, you know, they're trying to do some shit. So fuck it. Shout
also, big time listeners of DFZ Radio, big supporters of Black Market Cultivator and Heavy Tea Grow Show. So thank you everyone who called in. We're gonna go for the Heavy Tea Grow Show. You're gonna want to tune in because this one's gonna be one for the holiday books.
This is the Christmas show and the clout show.
That's it. DFZ Radio, Farm to Table Cannabis, proudly broadcast on High Times TV. Other than that, we out.